Prospects is a very interesting product which we've recently launched. It is addressing the needs of SMEs which are operating either in Malta or outside of Malta. The target market, as I said, is SMEs, and the target IPO, the amount of money that they will be collecting from the investing public, will be up to 5 million euros. We feel that this is a very appropriate amount for SMEs because it will tend to finance the most needs of this type of organization. I think it's fair to say that SMEs make up 99% of the Maltese economy and are the lifeblood of our economy, and it is important that these SMEs have a new access to finance option which will act complementary to the traditional banking finance options that they have available. The idea is for Prospects to be used as a source of finance, both in respect of the issue of equity as well as corporate bonds. And these will help SMEs, which are mostly family-run businesses, to address succession planning issues as well as to finance their growth opportunities and other investment needs that they may require from time to time. SMEs require different forms of financing, and it's safe to say that whether they come to market for equity or else corporate bonds in terms of financing, both will require that they make the grade in terms of corporate governance, transparency and obviously marketability. So I think one of the biggest benefits for the SME, besides getting the actual access to finance, which is what they need, is that they're going to be more present in the market because they will be admitted prospects. This gives them greater visibility. It also implies a certain amount of efficiency because they will be required to upgrade their internal operations in line with corporate governance standards that are required by the market. To this end, we will be facilitating, or they will be employing, engaging a corporate advisor who will be responsible to ensure that these companies are of the right level of corporate governance and they make the grade essentially to be able to be admitted to prospects. In this way, we will be ensuring that there is a process to select the right level of companies, the right quality of companies to come to market, and which will therefore be offering their financial instruments to the investing public. I think we have an obligation to the market as well as to the investing public to be careful as to who is eligible to be admitted to prospects.
Basically, exchanges are like any other businesses, and they have different business models and different bases for their income and for the clients that they service. It's obvious for the large, very large exchanges that have liquidity, then it's all about volumes. It's all about trying to get as much volume as they can onto their platforms. They have the technology that is allowing them to do this as well. And obviously with more volumes, then of course you can put your transaction costs down. That is not what smaller exchanges are about. Business models are different. If we look at ourselves, then we are looking at listing as being the clients that we want to attract. So it's not about liquidity, it's not about volume. How do we compete? Because of course we service different types of clients. As I said, there are some clients who want the volumes, there are smaller companies who have less liquidity, who have different reasons for coming to the market, and therefore what they look for is a smaller, perhaps a more user-friendly, in the sense that there's a more personal relationship with the companies, there's more guidance as well, which obviously for the large exchanges it does not make business sense to deal with these small clients. The focus of our business development over the next, I would say, near future, few years, is really going to be twofold. One is going to focus very much on international business. The Maltese market is finite. We haven't reached saturation yet. We are still very committed to the local market. However, if we want real growth now, we really need to get clients from overseas, get companies from overseas, both EU and non-EU, who may perhaps be seeking a listing venue which gives them particular services or benefits. Apart from that, of course, we also provide the full value chain for a transaction because we also run the post-trading infrastructure. We have invested very heavily in technology that gives us connectivity, particularly around the EU and to other markets and other post-trading infrastructures. And that connectivity obviously makes it even easier for the side of the investors to actually enter into our market. So I would say that we're looking at both sides of the transaction, both the supply and the demand, obviously offering the different levels of service to the different clients.